like you're looking through a telescope. You see where you're gonna be, growing, getting better. You're not the person they see. Can't be mad at the things you've been through, 'cause they built your muscle. Now you're stronger than you've ever been. They can't stop your hustle. Your faith ain't never small.
Precious Lord God.
It ain't
no
game.
Why didn't he fix it in the beginning?
It ain't no game.
Well, why didn't he fix it in the beginning?
It ain't no game.
Well, okay, you said that. Why didn't he fix it in the beginning?
It ain't no game. Right?
Okay, I know you're not, but so am I. So, right? So here's a real question. Why didn't he fix it in the beginning?
All right, simply because of this. Okay. Because of this, right? Because he gave man dominion.
Mm.
Now you got dominion, you're doing with it. He didn't say, hey, listen, I'll give you dominion as long as you keep it out of Satan's hand.
Mm.
Right? He didn't say that. He said, do what you want with it. Mm. Go forth and repopulate the earth. And they went.
They did that.
That's right.
They did that.
That's right. So what? So he came, he talked to people, only if you heard him. Mm. Only if you heard him.
Okay,
they call them prophets.
That happened.
Prophets.
That,
and they spoke. Right. What? You asked me why didn't he do it?
I'm asking you why didn't he fix it?
I told you.
No, he did fix it. See, the prophets came down here warning what's coming in the future. My question was specific. Why didn't he fix it then?
I told you.
He told you.
Because man owned it. It's his will.
He didn't tell me.
Yeah,
he didn't tell me. Wait. I got one more thing. See, him fixing it doesn't have anything to do with my free will. I don't even know why you brought that up, right?
Him fixing
this doesn't have nothing to do with my free will.
It got everything to do about your free will.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so anyways, if he saw a problem, right, and he has all this knowledge, he can see the future, he knows way down the line it's not going to work out, right, that the change has to come, why didn't he do it immediately?
He saw the problem. The problem is, man didn't think it was a problem.
Mm-hmm.
They think they know more than God.
Mm-hmm. Man didn't create yourself.
God gave the creation to man. It belongs to him.
True.
Right? It's his. Mm-hmm. Right? Now, he invited God in. I don't know about you. I invited God in.
Mm. I did too.
Did he come on his own?
No.
No, he didn't break down the door. He won't come in on his own.
Oh,
you
he did that
him.
All over the Old Testament. I am your God.
He had
is
to.
Is what he said.
That's right.
Right?
That's
now,
right.
Today, it's like he's hiding some doggone where, and you got to go find him and beg him to come into your life.
In the Old Testament, he
stepped out like a G, right? He said, behold, I created you. This is what it is. These are my commandments. That's what a God does, right? But today, he's hiding. Then he might be inside you. And he's turned the cheek on everything, right? And everything is done by grace, but not really, because, you know, that grace really isn't in play. If you do certain things, then you won't. You see, now I'm confused.
I know, because you're confusing me. You're getting confused.
Uh-oh.
You know, I mean.
Okay.
Go on, Jeff.
Well, I was making a comment from earlier when we were talking about sins being taken away. Pastor said, well, that sin wasn't, it was only covered, you see, right?
Yeah, and by the bulls and goats and
So what about the scripture in Romans, since we all love Romans?
Okay.
I was going to take
the
Old Testament.
Romans become part of the gospel?
Huh?
You said Romans was in the gospel.
He said it's part of the gospel, so I don't want to dispute that, but just going to take scripture from the book he loves.
Go ahead. What scripture?
4:7.
Romans what?
4. Or you could read from 1 to 7 to get the full meat.
Romans 4?
Yes. And please don't stop, because I know there's passionate stuff you're going to find along the way. Stop.
Okay.
But
read.
Go ahead, read it.
What shall we say then, that Abraham our father has pertaining to the flesh is found? For if Abraham were justified by works, he had whereof the glory, but not before God. For what saith the scriptures? Abraham believed God, and it was counted unto him for righteousness. Now to him that worketh is the reward not reckoned of grace, but of debt. But to him that worketh not, but believeth on him that justifieth the ungodly, his faith is counted for righteousness. Even as David also described the blessedness of the man unto whom God imputeth righteousness without works, saying, blessed are they whose iniquities are forgiven and whose sins are covered.
Okay.
Keep going?
No,
that's it, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh. And I'm saying that, isn't that still, that's in the New Testament, so isn't it talking about us here?
No, he's that talking about David and Abraham.
Mm-hmm. He's referring back to the old.
David and Abraham.
Right, but Paul is not saying that for nothing.
If no.
You can continue.
Well, David, David mm-hmm. said, uh-huh. David said in the Psalms, even as David also right. described, blessed the blessedness of mm-hmm. the man unto whom God imputeth righteousness without
right.
works,
right.
saying, blessed are they whose iniquities are right. forgiven and okay. whose sins are covered.
Right. Go ahead. Keep going. Right.
Blessed is the man to whom the Lord will not impute sin. Mm-hmm. Cometh this blessing then upon the circumcision only, upon the uncircumcision also? For we say it that faith was reckoned to Abraham for righteousness. How was it then reckoned? When he was in circumcision or in uncircumcision? Not in circumcision, but in uncircumcision. For he received the sign of the circumcision, a seal of the righteousness of the faith which he had being yet uncircumcised, okay. that he might be the father
of all of them that believe. Though they not circumcised, that righteousness might be imputed unto them also. So you see, this is what I'm talking about. See, circumcision was a law. See, what this is saying here is saying that pretty much if you get the right meat of it or the right description here, it's saying that before Abraham, the reason that faith was imputed for Abraham is because way before he become circumcised, he believed God. And because he believed God, he went and get himself circumcised because he believed God. Not because he thought circumcision of the foreskin of the private area would take him to heaven. He didn't believe it like that. He believed God before he was circumcised. He believed there is a God and that God spoke to him and he believed him. And because he believed him, when God says for him to get circumcised, he did. Because he believed him. And that's how I see the law when I'm talking about the law, that I'm passionate about, the law of God. It's not that the law is gonna take me to God. It is believing in Jesus Christ that takes me to God. And because I believe in Jesus Christ, then I ought to do the will of God, which is whatever he says in scripture, because I love him and I have to do what he told me to do.
Okay, suppose.
And that's how I'm seeing it.
Suppose
just as you just read here.
Suppose you
Why
don't.
Do you have to come with suppose I don't? Then I don't love him.
Yeah, all right. Then you go to heaven.
How could I don't love him and go to heaven, Pastor?
Huh? Because he's a savior of the ungodly.
Come on, man. See, this is...
The Bible says he saves ungodly.
Right.
No, wait a minute.
No. But
no,
those
wait a minute.
Who hate God
because
will not go to heaven.
Because, see, I'm not talking about the haters. Yeah. I'm talking about the grace because right. that's
well,
what you brought it in.
No,
so
no,
Abraham,
no.
Abraham was under grace.
Remember what I just answered you. I said this example here is the perfect example to what I'm talking about because it says, way before Abraham, the reason it was credited to Abraham as righteousness is because way before Abraham gets circumcised, he believed God. So he did not get circumcised to go to heaven.
Mm-hmm.
He gets circumcised late after he believed because God asked him to, because he believed God, he do it. So then, that's why he was credited to him. And then I said, this is the same way I believe it. I believe in Jesus Christ, and because God says to do these things, I do it because
okay.
I believe him.
Okay.
Hold on. Then
All
you
right.
said, suppose I'm going... I'm giving a summary of what you just said to me, what just happened here. And then you said, suppose I don't do them.
Yeah.
And I said, before you said that, I said, because I love him, I do it. And you said, well, suppose you don't do it. And I said, well, if I don't do it, then I don't love him. Which equal, in my understanding, I hate him. Because only if I hate him, I won't do it.
See them extremes?
Well,
what happens to gray
I'm trying to...
There is gotta be a gray area, because you can love God and not fulfill the promises or the voice of God. That, a whole lot that, of people that, who come okay. into
then
this.
You know what that is?
See,
you know what
see, that you is? Keep telling me to hold up.
No, don't interrupt.
But then you know when I get is? Started, you interrupt
know
me.
Is? You know what that is? We know what that is? Huh? That's called an accident.
See, let me tell you what it is, right?
That's why
your salvation never depended on how much you love God.
That's right. But
it always depended first. On how much God loved you.
That's right.
Okay.
God saved you because he loved you. You
first.
And you responded with love towards true. Him after you began to let's know
stick,
him.
Let's stick to what the scripture says you in Romans chapter 4 about Abraham.
Okay.
Abraham's faith. Let's respond to what the word says instead of our intellect.
Can I finish?
Go ahead.
Right? Mm-hmm. All right. So Abraham lived in grace, right? Everything before the law showed up, God did according to his grace, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. Now, Abraham never said mm-hmm. when Abraham met God that he loved God. It had nothing to do with love. Mm-hmm. It had to do with believing.
Mm-hmm. See, for you, you're going you about the law. God, you know how you're going about much. The law that I'm talking about?
Yeah.
You're talking about the law as though it started on Mount Sinai.
Okay.
That's how you're seeing it.
That's how the Bible describes it.
Well, no, that's not true.
It does.
The law doesn't... No, it's not true. Because even during the time of Adam and Eve, God says, do not eat. That's a law.
Ooh. That's true.
Isn't yep. it?
Yeah.
Isn't that a law?
That's yeah. true. Yeah, it's a law, but it's
so
not a law.
The day you eat of it, you shall surely die. That's the law of death.
Huh?
That's the law of death. Sin
that's
and
the law
death.
Of sin and death.
Sin and death. The day you eat of it, you shall surely die. See, you speak of the law as it started from Mount Sinai.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you say Abraham was before that. No, he wasn't. Because he believed God, and then he walked before God the way he ought to. The Bible testifies of that.
So, and the Bible also says, right, that from Adam to Moses, sin was in the world, but sin was not imputed where there was right. no law. Uh-huh. Right?
Excuse me. What does imputed mean, please?
Well, when you sin, God punishes you.
Mm-hmm.
God holds right. it to your
so
account.
He didn't punish Abraham? He didn't punish Adam?
No, he didn't punish Adam. He cursed the ground for Adam's right. sake.
Okay, he didn't right? curse Adam?
He didn't curse no. Adam. He yeah. cursed the ground for his sake. Yeah. Not
he
only
didn't
that.
Curse Adam.
No, he didn't. No, he didn't. Yeah. Adam died. Mm-hmm. Adam died. The day he hit that arm. And he didn't say, God did not
that's
say.
That's a punishment.
God did not say.
He had eternal life.
Next time you tell me to hold up, wait a minute. I'm going to do this. But listen. Listen. Now listen.
Oh, man.
Listen. God never said, Adam, if you eat of the tree in the midst of the garden, I'm going to kill you.
You said you shall surely die.
But the tree killed him.
Well, we don't know who killed him.
I do. Yeah. I don't know.
Who put the tree there?
God did.
So who killed him? So
God didn't kill him.
Hold on. So if I put a poison in here and I put it on the table, huh?
Actually, you could say his choice killed him.
His choice did, right? Yeah. Adam deliberately disobeyed. Right.
Okay, right. I'll agree with you.
That's story. Right. Adam,
would you say that's a law?
Listen, don't eat of that. That's a choice.
Don't eat of that.
Choice.
That's a choice.
Pastor, what make law in the scripture? That's why we keep saying the 10, and I keep saying there's a lot more. What makes law in scripture? What's law in scripture is every time God says, don't or do. Don't or do. Those are laws.
And every time you broke a law, right, blood had to be shed. Would you admit that?
Yes.
Okay. All right, so if the blood of Jesus took care of all them laws, right, then if you broke a law, then there is no punishment.
And that's where you're going when he says that from Adam, sin were not imputed. Because then, when we're talking about those sacrificial laws that we're talking about,
they wasn't from Adam to Moses.
Uh-huh. When we're talking about those sacrificial laws,
uh-huh.
But that doesn't say that there was not a law in place. Okay, because when God told Adam, "Do not eat of that," that was a law.
And he died. And he died. Come on.
Okay, so what is a law?
Yeah, spiritually.
Huh?
What is a law? Does a law have to be written? Can it be verbal? Can a law be insinuated? Or does it have
That's
to be specific? What is a law? It's perspective.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's definitive, and sometimes it's not. There are laws that are written and unwritten. Laws that are spoken and not spoken. I mean, you just know. Like, I had an issue with a cop the other day, right? Guy parking on the sidewalk. The cop came out and said, where is it posted? You can't park on the sidewalk.
Are you serious?
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
You know
what?
The cop said, where is it posted that you can't park on the sidewalk while the car is sitting right on the sidewalk? You know, I mean, you know, laws are laws, but they don't have to be written. They don't have to be, you know what I mean, right? There's some spoken.
It's a perfect example. In my house, I have laws. I have laws. We call it rules.
Right.
I have rules.
Same difference.
But I don't write. You're not going to find a book in my house say, okay, this book is written by Joshua.
So we know to do some things and we know not to do some
okay,
things.
Okay, so all I'm saying is that what's your little girl's name?
Sarah.
Now, Sarah, she break the law. Bust the knickknack, throw a tantrum, break the law.
Just dime Sarah out.
That's like, that draws Joshua closer to it. It doesn't separate them. Right? All right, right.
That's the closeness.
That's the closeness. And then there's reconciliation after the hand comes, right?
Sure.
All right, but see, with God, your law, the sin that separated between man and God. Mm. There was no reconciliation between them until the blood was shed. And then now he draws nigh unto you. You draw nigh unto him. Now I can admit, right, that after salvation has taken place, after I became saved, I wanted to work towards relationship.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I started to love him because he first loved
me.
You know what I mean? And I don't want to do the things that are contrary to him because of this love relationship, not because of a law. Right? First Adam broke the law, right? And what'd he do? Yes. I hid myself.
He sure did. That's
right?
What he said.
I break a law, I can go to him boldly.
Well, okay.
You know what I mean?
Interject.
Why? Because my sin don't separate us.
Interjection.
Which is,
come on.
Interjection. You see, right there is a prime example of what I'm talking about. You can know you can go boldly to the throne of grace because you've been told that, right? And it's already been done way before you. So you got all kind of examples. Adam didn't. So he did what any man would do, man. He did something he wasn't supposed to do. He hid. Kids do it all the time. We do it all the time as adults when we break the law. He acted like a total human being.
Run from the police.
I don't think there's any difference other than knowledge. You got more knowledge than he had.
In that
particular sense. Okay? In that particular sense. Because see, he was the first. Right?
But
there was no
it's not true.
There was no example before him.
No, not true. Adam had a direct conversation with God who said, Adam, don't do it.
You had a direct
say to him, if you do it, come to me and then I'll help you out.
You had a direct
he said you'll die.
Excuse me.
What? Huh?
You had a direct conversation with Buster that told you don't do it. You did it and then you tried to hide.
That's right.
Right. Why?
Because I wanted to do it my way, just like Adam did.
Adam wanted to do it his way.
Right? Adam had a choice. Eve had no choice. She was deceived, but Adam had a choice.
Right.
And he said, listen, that woman that he gave me, now she looks fine now. She's naked. You know what I mean?
She never knew him.
And he said, listen, I'm getting naked. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
He bit too. But he did it. He did it deliberately.
Well, what does that
he deliberately mean? Disobeyed.
He did.
Right?
Yeah.
And because he deliberately disobeyed.
The scripture didn't say that.
No, the scripture doesn't
say. Not all the stuff I put in there, but no.
Deliberately disobeyed.
The scripture doesn't say a lot of things, but see, that's a mindset thing. How do you know he felt like that? That's a human mindset
thing. The Bible says he felt like that.
Oh, well, who was there to need his mind to write it?
God was there.
God wrote that?
He saw the whole thing.
And God wrote that?
Yeah, every word. He breathed inspiration into the man. You believe it or not. We don't need to debate that. We don't
need to debate if God wrote the Bible or not.
No, but God, right? God didn't say Adam did that deliberately.
I think we do.
Yeah, he did. Adam deliberately disobeyed.
He did.
Because you know why? You know why I say that? If Adam was not deceived, we wouldn't be here.
Yes,
Adam wasn't deceived.
It depends on what you believe.
No, he was
deliberately disobeyed.
Yeah, he was deceived.
She was deceived.
There
right.
There were people here before Adam.
Yeah, Adam.
It depends on what you believe, right?
That's why I said
you chose to believe this. Right?
You know why I say that, Pastor? Uh-huh. It's because willful sin. There is no forgiveness for willful sin.
Willful sin?
Willful sin.
Willful sin?
Willful sin.
Every sin. Well, 90% of the sins that are committed.
Well, why did he come?
Hey, I know what you're saying is true, but I'm telling you what the Bible says.
Hebrews? You know something?
I believe
you get from Hebrews.
Why it says willful, there are no forgiveness for willful sin.
You know something?
Yeah, that's Hebrews.
Adam died.
Mm-hmm.
The moment he bit the fruit. When Eve bit it, nothing happened.
Pastor, say spiritually. Right? Say Adam died spiritually. Because if you don't, we're thinking that he just collapsed like
that. Yeah, well, he died spiritually.
So I was saying Eve wasn't punished then?
Yeah, Eve was punished.
Okay.
Eve was punished. So Satan was punished. But when he got to Adam, he punished the ground for Adam's sin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He cursed the ground.
Again, they were both deceived.
He cursed the ground, yeah.
No. All right. Let's use that for another 2 weeks, right?
Amen.
Let's bring that back in two weeks.
Okay. In 2 weeks?
Yeah. No, 1 week. I'm sorry.
Next week.
I wish y'all could find it now.
We're not done with the law.
Huh?
We're not done with the
law. Well, let's keep on to it. Let's bring back some stuff, because the law's got a lot of stuff in this Bible that says, man. And the truth is, listen.
I think we have to define what's law and what's not law.
I think we know.
It seems like we keep saying the Ten Commandments. I think there's more.
I think that's the one God gave. The Bible said God gave 10.
He gave them all.
Huh?
He gave them all.
He didn't give them all.
The law.
Pharisees gave a few.
Well.
They kept adding to it.
The law that God, like I said, when we talk about the law of
sin and death,
for example, there's a law of bestiology,
bestiology.
That's in the Leviticus law. That's God who gave that.
When?
And there was many in Leviticus.
Oh, in that story?
Yeah. There's a bunch of laws. It's not, it's the Ten Commandments is not their own. What the Ten Commandments to me is, it's a summary of all God's law. Only a God could do that, could summarize all of it in those 10 words.
Go ahead.
Or 10 sayings.
But I guess the problem I have, I'm going to do some more research, but the problem I have is that if we're still under the law or some laws,
That's why sometimes the church will talk loud.
I'm
we're not under the law. No, the Bible says we're not under the law. But we have to specify, I said, which law. Is it talking about the law of God, the royal law? Or is it talking about the law of the flesh, the law of sin and death?
Okay, so
define it.
So what you're saying, right, that
we are not under the law of sin and death, is what I'm saying.
Go ahead, Nate.
So we're under the law of God. We're not under the law of sin and death. That's what I'm saying.
Go ahead. I'll try to get in next week.
Go ahead.
No, I'm done.
So what I wanted to say was, man, when we study this thing, right, and this is what I have come up with, right? No, I didn't make it up, right? Is that we omit one variable that is extremely important when studying these scriptures, man. Because see, these scriptures, right, were written by people inspired by God, right? But there's still that people flavor on them, right? And if you don't believe me, read all the three of the Gospels. It's all three different perspectives, or four, however many Gospels there are. So their flavor is on it. If God wrote it, it would be exactly the same, right? But it's not. You see, people have different perspectives and mindsets on different things. So they react and respond differently to different situations and circumstances, right? When we read this, we see, what's the word I'm looking for? When it's absolute, right? Paul says,
hey, if you sin, this is going to happen, or we can't do that. If a man thinks like this, then this is what he is.
Well, that's not necessarily true. That's just what Paul said. But, and Paul was a man.
But here's the thing. I'm not finished.
Go ahead. I'm gonna give it to you anyway. Go ahead.
Well, I'm just saying, right? You know, I mean, for us the Gentiles, see, I'm trying to figure out, you know. There's a separation here between us and the Israelites, you know, when it comes to these laws.
Yes.
Well, see, man, so I mean, law wasn't imputed to us. You understand what I'm going to say?
Yeah, but see, this is what he said.
You just got to keep talking loud, and then they won't interrupt you.
He interrupted me. After he said I can go.
He been waiting forever, man.
He said I can go. I yielded my time. Now he interrupted. Go ahead.
I'm going to get an egg timer next time.
Let's do that. No, I'm going to, because I'm going to save my stuff for next week.
No, go ahead.
Even with that, in that little bit that he said, right? But brother, you're always under a law. You're under the law here in Springfield. They're called rules.
Well, we understand.
That's all. Law is just a term that Paul uses.
But we're not talking about the law of Springfield. We're talking about the word.
This is what I'm saying to you. Right? Paul is talking about...
Let him finish.
Okay, go ahead. I know what he's saying.
And we're talking about grace. And we seem to keep leaving grace out of the picture.
Well, we keep leaving Christ out of the picture,
you know. I mean, we keep playing with words, you know, did he fulfill? Was the law destroyed? You know, nobody ever said the law wasn't good. The main thing is that whether we as human beings could not fulfill that law.
And I just agree with you.
Amen.
I think that there were people, individuals, that did fulfill that.
Let's put it like
but on the overall, no, the human race didn't.
Well, so, can I put it differently? We couldn't keep the law.
So let me tell you something Paul said in the law, chapter 2. Chapter 2, just one scripture. Just one scripture, and I'm going to move back, right?
Where?
It's at chapter 2, verse 14.
Romans?
13 and 14, right? So he says, for not the hearers of the law are just before God, but the doers of the law shall be just. For when the Gentiles, which have not the law, do by nature the things contained in the law, these having not the law are a law unto themselves. Right?
Okay. Well,
so that just says that the law never came to the Gentiles.
Let me put it this way. The point is that if you guys go back and you read it correctly, and do some more research on this, you will find that there were certain laws in that scripture that was applied only to the Israelites and not the other nations. But there were other laws that were applied. I'll give you a brief example, the land law, because there were many laws that are applied solely to the land of Israel, you know, on how to maintain it, how to keep it, and all that. Those laws were not applied to us, to Gentiles, other, meaning the other nations. They were only applied to Israel, you see? But with what you said about keeping the law, see, the point I'm making is that there's a famous saying in Israel is that we don't keep the law.
It's like you're looking through a telescope. You see where you're gonna be. Growing, getting better. You're not the person they see. Can't be mad at the things you've been through, 'cause they built your muscle. Now you're stronger than you've ever been.